Good day, and welcome to Mission Control Houston, where flight controllers are monitoring the activities of the Expedition 33 crew aboard the International Space Station. On board, of course, is the commander, Sunny Williams, along with her crew members since July, Yuri Malenchenko of the Russian Federal Space Agency and Akihiko Hoshide of the Japan Aerospace Exploration Agency. In addition, Nally recently joining the crew in October, our NASA astronaut Kevin Ford, as well as Russian cosmonauts Oleg Novitskiy and Evgeny Tarelkin. They will be taking over the operations of the International Space Station when the expedition commander and her colleagues depart, coming up on November the 18th. Among the experiments being used today are the Madaka osteoclast experiment. The crew is scheduled to be doing some photography of the Madaka fish in that newly arrived aquarium. The experiment is looking at bone resorption, and that is the process by which osteoclasts break down bone and release minerals so that new bone can be built. Scientists believe that the cause for the decrease in bone mineral density in space is related to this, and the Madaka fish is a good model in the animal world for life research. And the Japanese experiment folks are studying the effects of microgravity on the osteoclast activity and the gravity sensing system of these fish, using them as a model for the human body. The fish are doing well, but there have been some additional bubbles introduced into the aquarium module, and tomorrow the crew is going to conduct a procedure to remove those extra bubbles, but otherwise the fish are doing well. Both Williams and Hoshide have been involved in continued troubleshooting of the waste and hygiene compartment. That's the Russian toilet unit in the U.S. operating segment of the space station. It hasn't been working right since Friday. They had previously replaced a pre-treat injector pump and worked on several other pieces of equipment, but the alert lights were continuing to show early today that the pre-treated urine wasn't of the right mixture to be fed into the water recycling system. Eventually, that water ends up being reused by the crew as drinking water and to prepare food and for other uses. Williams did a lot of inspections, and then they replaced the pre-treat tank, and that seemed to be the job that did the trick. All the following tests were nominal. The lights went off as they were supposed to, and now the crew has been cleared to use that toilet. The crew members also are using ultrasound equipment to image blood vessels as part of the integrated cardiovascular experiment, and that's looking at the human heart and how it tends to shrink or atrophy during long-duration space flights. They've also been taking readings overnight as they sleep as part of the experiment and using an electroencephalograph, and there have been some trouble with the batteries that are used to power that device, so the crew has also been troubleshooting those batteries and chargers. Jury's still out on whether it's a problem with the batteries themselves or with the way the batteries are seating in the specialized chargers that are used to keep them ready for use. Kevin Ford also is getting ready to do some intraocular eye pressure tests as part of the routine medical examinations and continuing studies of how long-duration spaceflight can change astronauts' vision. And the Russian cosmonauts moved up some of their routine maintenance of the toilet on their end of the station, which is virtually the same as the one in the waste and hygiene compartment. But now that the newer toilet has been fixed, they've shifted that a little bit later in the day since it's not as critical. The idea is to make sure that we've got at least one working toilet aboard the space station at all times, but now we have two. The crew also continued departure preparations for Sunny Williams, Aki Hoshide, and Yuri Malenchenko, who are scheduled again to depart the International Space Station on Sunday, November the 18th. Here's a rundown of all of the coverage we have planned for the change of command ceremony on Saturday the 17th, the farewells and undocking and landing on November the 18th, and then the post-landing video file on Monday the 19th. And, of course, the newly arrived crew members, Ford, Novitskiy and Tarelkin continued their orientation aboard the space station, getting used to their new home in space and getting a full rundown by their offgoing veteran crew members so that they can continue operations until the next crew members arrive. That'll be Tom Marshburn of NASA, Romanenko of the Russian Federal Space Agency and Chris Hadfield of the Canadian Space Agency, who eventually will become the first Canadian commander of the International Space Station. Those crew members are continuing their training in Star City, Russia today. They are at the Gagarin Cosmonaut Training Facility conducting rendezvous and docking simulations, and Marsha Byrne is getting ready for his return to Russia next week for their final pre-launch training. This is Mission Control Houston.